Hi everyone, welcome to Ahmed Academy. In this video, we're going to be covering what is informed consent and its key elements and what actually makes up an informed consent. And we're going to touch on that with context and also explain it through with an easy example to understand as well. So the learning objectives for this video is to cover what is informed consent, its key elements, talk about an example and how to gain a valid consent, and also go through some sources that we used to make this video possible. So first of all, what is informed consent? And informed consent is obtained once the patient is given all the relevant information tailored to their treatment plan, given enough time to consider and make a sound decision. So once you've presented all the information relevant to their treatment, you have to confirm their understanding. And this is something that is emphasized by the Dental Protection Indemnity Company on their sources when they are talking about the informed consent. Is they go on to say, to use this term, do need to appreciate the focus should be on understanding rather than the provision of information alone. So it's not only about providing information, but more so about making sure your patient understands what you, the information that you've explained to them. And you have to also allow opportunities for questions and answers. Any questions they may have, you have to answer fully and perhaps with some evidence base as well. The consent must be voluntary, informed, always subject to change, and within the person's capacity. And you have to always note down what sort of capacity of a person you're dealing with to make sure they're able to weigh up the pros and cons of what you're presenting to them. So we spoke about the key elements on basically what really makes up a consent informed. Informed meaning you providing a lot of information to them in regards to the treatment that you're proposing. So first of all, why the treatment is necessary, consequence of no treatment if no treatment is done, treatment options, what sort of options are available in order to rectify the issue that you have identified, each risks associated with each treatment, its benefits, likely prognosis, and also risks and benefits of each individual treatments, and also you may provide a recommended option here as well, and the cost of each treatment, and also how much time and number of appointments is going to take you to complete that. So an easy example here that I've got is some tooth decay that you've identified during your exam appointment with your patient, and you presented to them the fact that you've found this bit of decay on their tooth and perhaps show it to them on the radiograph, and you present them the options and so why the treatment is necessary. In this case, you would explain that the decay is into the live dentine layer, past the enamel layer, and if the no treatment, the treatment options for that will be to either go something with something direct restorations with composite, amalgam or GIC, or something indirect such as an inlay, or even no treatment, and that is always an option. No treatment is always an option. Consequence of no treatment, so in this case the decay may advance to the nerve and further breakdown may occur, causing the patient to lose the tooth altogether in the future. The risks might be bleeding, nerve exposure, sensitivity, damage to adjacent teeth. Some benefits will be removal of active disease, preventing progression, increased prognosis of the teeth, reducing pain and sensitivity. The likely prognosis, I've put some evidence based on how long an amalgam and a composite lasts, but you could certainly make this a bit informal with your patient to talk, to give your experience on which one is best, rather than fully relying on the evidence that you got perhaps from a study. And also you may, based on experience, once again you provide your recommended option here. That's where option 7 comes in, and also presenting the cost of the treatment, where amalgam costs 65 quid, around 65 quid, where composites can cost anywhere from 100 and onwards, and inlays, which is the indirect restoration option here, can cost anywhere between 250 and above. And the number of appointments required here, so if the patient goes for indirect restoration, it'll be only one appointment, where if they go for an indirect option, you're looking at two separate appointments where you take impressions one and then fit in the next one. So that was a quick overview of what informed consent is, guys. So all it is that you're providing all these pointers, points of information, you're delivering all of it to the patient and making sure they understand it. That's what makes it informed. And then that is your consent, and you can consider it informed as well. So further reading on this topic is available on the GDC Principle 3, which I'm sure you're aware of in the UK, and then the DDU and the Dental Protection Indemnity Companies have their own take on it, which all three links will be in the description section below for you to have a look at as well. So thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed and benefited from this video, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. It helps me out a lot. Give this video a like as well, and leave anything that I may have missed out in the comments or your opinion about this video, and I'll catch you in the next one.